Hi everyone, welcome to Behind the Stumps with Anuj. This is your host, and today on our show Wings of Fire we have India's next gen, we could say the next young wicketkeeper batsman Yastika Bhatia. Hello ma'am, welcome to the show.
Hello, thank you.
So aapka abhi lockdown kaise ja raha hai?
Bas chal raha hai abhi, acha chal raha hai waise to. Boys ke saath matches khel rahi hu, thoda ये सब चीजों से दिमाग हट रहा है तो अच्छा लग रहा है।
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, क्रिकेट इज ऑलवेज समथिंग दैट यू नो अपना पूरा कंसंट्रेशन उससे थोड़ा हट जाता है, थोड़ा जो भी हाँ। सब बुरे चीजें चल रही है तो उससे थोड़ा बेटर हो जाता है। सो यू नो स्पीकिंग अबाउट यू नो बीइंग अ क्रिकेटर, यू नो इट इज सीन दैट यू नो वुमेन्स क्रिकेट जो इंडिया में हुआ है वो 2017 वर्ल्ड कप में जब फाइनल में पहुंचे हम, और अनफॉर्चुनेटली इंग्लैंड से हारे, वो गेम हारना नहीं चाहिए था एक्चुअली पर हारे, पर फिर भी द रिकॉग्निशन दैट वी गॉट इट वाज सिमिलर टू दैट ऑफ द 1983 वर्ल्ड कप, जहां पे कपिल देव के विन ने एक रेवोल्यूशन लाया था। वहीं से 2017 से अभी चार साल में इंडिया में इतना जो फीमेल क्रिकेटर्स का टैलेंट आया है, व्हाट डू यू फील, यू नो दैट वाज दैट अ टर्निंग पॉइंट फॉर यू टू, और आपका क्या जर्नी था, मतलब व्हाट मोटिवेटेड यू टू टेक द गेम अप?
Yeah, definitely it was a turning point. I started playing when I was 8 years old. So I first used to play badminton and basketball at school, and then football and all the sports I used to play, like swimming, karate. So one day my dad came up to me like, do you want to try another sport? So I was like, yes daddy, come on, let's do it. So he took me and my sister to a club at Polo Ground. So we went there and we started our game, and we really loved the game, playing first with tennis ball, then with cricket ball, then slowly we started progressing, and later on it developed into my passion, and now I have never looked back since then. And when 2017 World Cup was played in England, that time I was in my home, I was watching the game very closely, and it was a really a heartbreak for all of us watching the team losing from such a great position which we were in. So, but it was really a turnover for everyone, because after that we were all recognized. Even the domestic players were started recognizing by people like, this is Yastika. She, my neighbors used to tell other children that she also plays cricket. Look, Didi is playing cricket. She goes out for practice. And everybody, my relatives started encouraging me. First, they were not encouraging, but they all, means everything changed from that point. They all started encouraging, like, you okay, it's nice, you are playing cricket, there is some future. Then IPL started for women's, so that was also means not IPL, women's T20 challenge started, so that was also like a turning point, and that also promoted women's cricket a lot in the country. So टीवी पे लाइव टेलीकास्ट आने लगे, और उसके बाद से भी काफी फर्क पड़ा है, लड़कियों ने गेम को टेक अप करना शुरू किया है, तो काफी सारे चेंजेस आए हैं।
सो यू नो हर एक के लाइफ में ऐसा एक परफॉर्मेंस रहता है, यू नो जैसे लाइक अगर मेरे लाइफ में किसी का अगर मैंने इंटरव्यू लिया हो कोई बड़े प्लेयर का, तो उसके बाद जो मुझे कॉन्फिडेंस आया है बाकी लोगों का इंटरव्यू लेने का, तो वैसे ही कोई ऐसे यू नो एज अ क्रिकेटर कोई एक ऐसा परफॉर्मेंस आपको याद है, बोले वो कोई भी लेवल पे हो, यू नो अंडर अंडर 19 के पहले हो या फिर अंडर 23 हो या कुछ भी हो, आपको ऐसा कोई परफॉर्मेंस जिससे आपको लगे कि यार ये मुझे गेम पसंद तो था पर मैं अभी इससे यू नो एज अ प्रोफेशनल स्पोर्ट आई कैन प्ले दिस गेम?
या व्हेन आई स्कोर्ड 145 अगेंस्ट हरियाणा ऑफ 131 बॉल्स, दैट वाज अ लाइफ मींस करियर changing point in my life, because in that innings I played really good strokes, and that was recognized by everyone, and all of them were congratulating me for my century, and it was a crucial knock in terms of our team for getting qualified in the tournament, and that boosted my confidence that I also belong to this level. Also, one more knock was there I had made a 64 not out. We were chasing 300 runs against NCA, means in the NCA we were playing inter NCA games, so we were chasing 300 plus score, and I walked into bat at number 4 at that time, and I made a 64 not out, and we were close to around 250 runs. We had reached 250 for 6, and that's when rain started, so match was called off. But I took it close to the point, like we were all started to believing that we can win, we can also chase 300. So that was one confidence boosting, because all the players were NCA level, everybody is experienced and everybody has represented India. So that was the level which started, means that was the innings which started boosting me, like I also belong to this level, I can also play at national level, international level.
Yeah, so you know, जो इंडिया के लिए कॉल अप रहता है नो, गिवन द फैक्ट दैट अभी हम T20 वर्ल्ड कप के भी फाइनल तक पहुंचे थे और ऑस्ट्रेलिया से हारे थे, सो एंड देयर इज नो शेम इन लूजिंग टू अ स्ट्रांग टीम लाइक ऑस्ट्रेलिया, पर क्या आपको आपका कॉल अप जो था यू नो इट वाज अ बिट अनएक्सपेक्टेड इन मेनी वेज फॉर द आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड, यू नो जो आपको साउथ अफ्रीका टीम के लिए कॉल अप आया था, प्लस उतना वो बड़ा गैप हुआ था, तो अगर समझो आपने कोविड के आउटब्रेक से पहले भी कोई परफॉर्मेंस किया रहेगा तो वो शायद से सिलेक्टर्स के इतना दिमाग में शायद नहीं रहा रहेगा, तो वर यू एक्सपेक्टिंग दैट एंड व्हाट वाज योर फैमिलीज रिएक्शन व्हेन यू गॉट द कॉल अप?
I had means before COVID, since 4 years, if you look at my records, then I have an average of 40 plus and as an opener, and a strike rate of 73. And plus I have 300s and I think 15, 16, 50s in the past 4 years. And in keeping also, I have contributed a lot. Means I have like almost 100 dismissals in 126 matches. So if you look at my record, I have been consistently performing. But what was the issue that we had a COVID break. So I was not expecting at all that I would get a chance immediately after the COVID break. But still, somewhere on the back of the mind, I was ready that in the upcoming series, because there were so many series, so I was at the back of the mind that in the upcoming series, I may get a chance. And because I had done well in India A also. So that was at the back of my mind. And my father, he had an intuition. He told me that dekhna beta, is baar tera selection hoga. Maine bola, papa kya baat kar rahe ho, aapko kaise pata chal raha hai ki mera selection hoga. To bole dekhna tu is baar bahut acha hoga, positive vibes aa rahe hai mere ko. Maine bola theek hai, dekhte hain. Fir achanak se WhatsApp group pe aaya ki India versus South Africa, congratulations, you are selected. So I was like totally over the moon, I could not believe. First I checked with my teammate, means Radha Yadav also plays for India. So I checked with her that is it the right group, means I have been added in the right group. She told yes, you have been added. So that was the time when I came to know, I was over the moon. And then I immediately called up my father that this is the news, I have been selected. So my father was in tears, like he was completely in tears, like wow, see I told you this dream will come true. And everybody was very happy and they were glad that my dream has come true, because it is one's dream when we start playing. Means nobody had expected when I started playing, but once you take up the sport professionally, then you look up to play for India someday. Right. So that was like a dream for me and it came true. And even the chief selector of Baroda team congratulated me, and Miss Rajkumari Gaikwad, she congratulated me and supported me, like you are going to do well in the series, don't worry. Like everybody congratulated me and all the BCA officials, my school, everybody, my club, everybody means congratulated me, and my coach also backed me up that you are going to do well, don't worry.
So you know, like it is like a dream come true, as you said. And you know, when you went into the dressing room, Indian dressing room, you got to see your heroes, you know, Harmanpreet Kaur, who played that brilliant knock of 171 in that World Cup. Then Smriti Mandhana, you know, many say that, you know, you and Smriti Mandhana have similar batting styles. एंड देन ऑब्वियसली योर गुड फ्रेंड राधा यादव. सो यू नो हाउ वाज द कैमराडरी, एनी एनेक्डोट्स दैट यू वुड लाइक टू शेयर ऑफ द ड्रेसिंग रूम?
Yeah, first when I went to the bus, I was sitting in the bus, so Haridi came and she has a routine, like she comes and she talks with all the youngsters. So when she saw me, she told that aapka naam kya hai, to main एकदम से ऐसे शॉक हो गई कि आप सामने से आके सीनियर प्लेयर बात कर रहे हैं. तो मैंने बताया कि मेरा नाम आस्तिका है. फिर उन्होंने और क्वेश्चंस पूछे, तो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा उनसे डिस्कस करके, सब बातें करके. फिर जैसे ड्रेसिंग रूम में गई तो सब सीनियर प्लेयर्स थे, लेकिन किसी ने भी मतलब ऐसे दिखाया नहीं कि वो सीनियर है. सब आके बात कर रहे थे सामने से. और मैंने भी जुलंदी से बात किया, बाद में मिताली राज से बात किया, और सब दीदियों से बात किया, तो काफी अच्छा कॉन्फिडेंस आया. जैसे राधा भी थी तो उसने भी अच्छा मुझे सपोर्ट किया कि देख तेरे को चांस मिला है तो तू सबसे फ्रेंकली बात कर और घुल मिल जा, क्योंकि जितना तू घुलेगी उतना तेरे लिए इजी रहेगा, उतना तू नेट्स में अच्छा कर पाएगी, मैच में अच्छा कर पाएगी. तो वही मेरे दिमाग में था कि मेरे को सबसे बात करनी है और मिक्सअप अच्छे से होना है. और मतलब थोड़ा नर्वसनेस तो लग रहा था ड्रेसिंग रूम के अंदर, सबको देख के बड़े बड़े प्लेयर्स हैं और सब कैसे अपने आप को कैरी कर रहे हैं. लेकिन जैसे जैसे मतलब नेट्स में मैं घुसी और बैटिंग शुरू हुई तो सबको अच्छी लगी. फिर हरमंदी ने मेरे को नाम भी दिया था, छोटे करके बुलाते थे मेरे को, तो वो भी अच्छा लगा. फिर मेरे बैटिंग के बाद आके मुझे बोले कि आप बहुत अच्छे बैटिंग करते हो, नाइस शॉट्स ऐसे करके, तो थोड़ा कॉन्फिडेंस आया. फिर दो तीन सेशन के बाद जैसे मैं प्रैक्टिस कर रही थी तो जुलंदी ने मेरे को बोला कि आप उन्होंने टिप्स दिए कि आप अपने बैटिंग पे काम करो, आप फिटनेस पे काम करो, और भी चीजें बताई उन्होंने, तो काफी सीखने को मिला टूर से, तो अच्छा लगा.
एंड वी नो दैट यू नो अनफॉर्चुनेटली यू कुडंट गेट अ चांस. मुझे लगा था यू नो कि जो डेड रबर वाला गेम था आखिरी गेम, एटलीस्ट उसमें चांस मिल सकता. बट नो, हाउ डू यू कीप योरसेल्फ मोटिवेटेड? यू नो जनरली इंडिया एक ऐसी कंट्री है जहाँ पे बीट मेन्स टीम और वुमेन्स टीम, अभी कॉम्पिटिशन इतना हो गया है कि यू नेवर नो दैट यू नो विच सीरीज माइट बी द लास्ट चांस दैट यू हैव टू प्रूव. और मतलब बहुत सारे लोग ऐसे भी आके गए कि यू नो एक स्क्वाड में नाम दिया पर फिर दे डिडंट गेट एन अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड देन दे हैड टू रिटर्न एंड देन दे हैड टू वेट फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम. सो हाउ डिड यू टेक इट इन योर स्ट्राइड यू नो दैट यू कुडंट गेट अ गेम?
या आई वाज डिसअपॉइंटेड बिकॉज आई वाज एक्सपेक्टिंग टू प्ले, बट ऑन द डे ऑफ द मैच आई वाज टोल्ड दैट यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू प्ले. सो दैट वाज लाइक ए हार्ट ब्रेक फॉर मी बिकॉज आई हैड प्रिपेयर्ड एवरीथिंग. Since last 15 days I was preparing in the lockdown, I mean sorry quarantine, I was preparing in the practice games and practices and match I was preparing. So it was heartbreak for me, but I took it in positive stride that maybe in the next series or maybe after that I will get a chance. I am confident of performing well and I will not look it as a setback, but I will look it as an opportunity that whenever I will get a chance I can prove myself in whatever format or whatever game I get a chance.
Yeah, so no the thing that you said that you know it is very commendable to you know take that in a positive way, you know, especially when you are preparing everything and then on the day if you are told that you're not playing, then that does play a role in you know, it might dishearten you, but you know you have shown that maturity, you know, at such a young age, and it is very important because you do need especially in India you do need patience because you know many players whom I have talked with, they have spoken about this that you know if you don't get opportunity it is very important to stay patient. So but then you know the England tour was announced, then the prospect of Indian women playing their first test match after a while and you know so I was covering the domestic matches of women's team and I was seeing that you know this Indrani Roy was you know scoring heaps of runs. So you know when her name was announced I wasn't shocked, but at the same time I felt disappointed that you know you without giving a chance, you were dropped from the England team. So, you know, how did you react to that? Or were you expecting that given the performance of the other two wicketkeepers?
Yeah, I mean, I was disappointed, but everything is part and parcel of the game. It comes as, we have to take it as it comes, and every day is a new day and every series is new series. So maybe they have dropped me this series, maybe they will pick me for any other series. But main is that I will not look at what happens in that result. I will look at what I have to do, that is process. And I have been working hard, I have been doing well in my process. So I don't feel I feel disappointed, but I don't feel disheartened, because I know that I can make debut soon and I can do well for my country.
Yeah, so now talking about the player contracts and everything, you know, there is a debate going on that, you know, why doesn't women's cricket get that much attention in India as much as men's cricket does? You know, with men's cricketers getting a top contract of 7 odd crores and women's cricketers getting just 50 lakhs. Do you think, does it concern you at the moment, or, you know, do you think that this is something that should change a lot? Because when I remember when last time I spoke with you, you were speaking about the possibility of the number of teams increasing in the women's IPL. You know,
yeah.
So women's IPL didn't happen this time also. And again, it depends, you know, how do you tackle with this? You know, what is the thought process? Do you get disheartened by the treatment like this? Or I would just like to know your opinion on this.
No, I think BCCI is doing wonderfully for women, because they have started the day and night test match. They have started so many tours for Indian team. They are now treating everything equally. They are giving good facilities for women. As far as equal pay is concerned, I think the gap will reduce slowly. And as more and more people watch the women's game, the revenue will be collected more, and slowly the salaries will also increase, the annual income means contract system will also increase. So I don't think it's a huge problem, but means the gap is long, but slowly and steadily it will decrease. And BCCI is doing lots of things for us. They have started women's test matches, so slowly they will look into it, and I hope they will do some more positive things in the future.
So are you expecting a women's IPL soon, like a full-fledged 8-team women's IPL, or do you think that
will
take time?
No, definitely I'm expecting it in a year or two, because there are many budding cricketers coming up. Like there are people who are ready to, means you might have looked in the IPL which happened last year in 2020. Even the Indian players who are playing for the main team are sitting out. So you can see the bench strength which is developing in India. So I think India is ready for a women's IPL, and it should happen really soon.
Well, thank you so much, ma'am. It was a pleasure talking to you on all the topics that, and I do hope that, you know, you are recalled to the Indian team soon, and we see you living your dream, that is winning the next World Cup for India.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay.